Forget about Beverly Hills. You've got 329 Beach Road.
This pool is definitely one of the largest pools you can get on Beach Road. Isn't it crazy?
Views like this, you'll never get sick of.
This one-of-a-kind resort welcomes you to 6 bedrooms, 6 bathrooms, and a 6-car garage. Heaven on earth is exactly how I will describe this property.
I am going to miss this property once it's sold.
This architecturally designed resort home is the lifestyle you've always dreamt of.
This, I need in my office. Welcome to Vlog 10. You're probably wondering why I'm in a jacuzzi right now, correct? Well, guess what? There's a jacuzzi here. I'm on the rooftop. You can fit 80 people here at 329 Beach Road, Blackrock. You saw me downstairs in the swimming pool. I've got a sick vlog full of luxury real estate in the most prestigious suburbs of Melbourne. Alright, so we're meeting this developer out here, and he's got a site down at Bulli, 1300 square meters. Got plans and permits for
eight townhouses, eight luxury townhouses with city views.
You really don't want to get run over by a car.
Definitely not.
It's a videographer? No, that's better. So he's got eight townhouses, he's got CBD views.
Correct.
10 minutes away from Melbourne CBD. Purchase price, $1.2 million. We're selling it on the market at $3 million.
Yep.
Potential commission is about $75,000. Should we disclose the commission?
28 days.
28 days exclusive authority.
Done.
We're going to take it to auction.
Yep.
$3 million plus $250,000 stamp duty plus build cost, site cost, $350 times 8, $2.8 million. So there's a good $1.5 million profit to be made in this one. And you want to know, you want to find out more about it? Give us a call right now. Let's go out and see the developer right now. Sitting right next to Mr. Nadal Amachi. He is the CEO of Amachi Architects, and we're based in Mount Waverley in Melbourne. Mr. Amachi, thank you so much for your time. And now, a little message that you'd like to pass on to all our viewers out there. What does success mean to yourself?
All right, I have to say it again.
Yeah, what does success mean to you?
Look, success, to be honest, the way I see it, is to continue that success and maintain it during the hard time.
A hard time?
Yeah, so that's success, because I could be successful in a certain period of time, then when you have a hard time and you forget about that success, this is not success to me. But success is to maintain your success and contingency, like with all time during your life.
How you react to,
and that's not only business wise, that's with your family, with your friends. You don't lose any one of them from you as your decision, you know?
Yeah. Now, how long have you been an architect for?
Oh, I've been an architect since 1992.
So I was 2 years old when you just got into the game?
Yes, baby.
Wow. Now, what do you love about architecture? Like, what did you get? Why did you get into this field?
I love architecture because I think I have a good imagination. Since when I'm a kid, I used to look at empty blocks and straight away imagine what's gonna happen in there.
I love it.
Plus, it's I enjoy actually come up with something new every day.
Good. So you're passionate about
drawing, and concept. It's about my life.
Sure. Do you visualize something before you draw it?
100%.
I love that. And how many projects would you say you've worked on?
Oh, hundreds.
Welcome to the Golden Mile of Riley. You were the shadow to my light. Did you feel us? Another star, you fade away. Afraid I... Definitely one of the finest design kitchens I've seen in a while. Where are you now? So guys, we're currently vlogging as well as Zed is doing a copy video right now. So we're currently behind the scenes, doing a vlog and copy video in one go. Let's go see where he is. Wow, is that made of flower petals or something? That is huge, but beautiful. Anyways, let's go find Zed.
Now this property offers your library inside your home. You actually don't even need to go to a library. One thing that fascinates me is definitely books. I educate myself on a daily basis. Simply read 10 pages before I go to sleep, and I read at least minimum 10-20 pages just before I go into work as well, because I feel like I need to know more than what I did yesterday. Does that make sense? I need to know more than what I did yesterday. And by that I mean, the more you learn, the more you will earn physically, financially, mentally. And books are great. You know, and by the way, you know what the best book in my eyes is? Like the Bible, the Quran, you know? They're religious books, you know, because I feel like religion was made to guide people towards the right way. You know, the whole purpose of our life is to be able to help each other out. And by that I mean, you know, the purpose of life is to give and not take anything back in return. And the more you give, the more you receive. So stop reading books, because I feel like religion books, in front of my eyes, are the best sales books out there, because it brings out the best out of you. I love a property with high ceilings. But forget about the ceilings, check this out. The whole house is automated. You can take selfies. And on top of that, you can travel all around the world. With a click of a button, you'll be able to see who's inside, who's not outside, because it's got camera surveillance. You can connect their surround sound speakers all around the property. The blinds, TVs, everything. Lights on, lights off. The whole house.
Alexa, give me a tour of the house.
To be a man and leave, I'll leave your safe grounds to find some distance higher. My lights for like my high. Well, I'll become a higher me. Oh, I don't know what it feels like.
Sometimes in real estate, it's not always fun and games. We make it look like it's wow and we have fun all the time, but right now my energy is so low.
I was just about to say, can you tell his energy is low? You've had a shit day, right?
I've had a really tough day today. I've had over 1,000 phone calls. You know, it's not always fun and games. You know, there's heaps of complaints that I had to deal with. Not that we get a lot of complaints, but just buyers, you know, are so tough to deal with. They want everything for nothing. Mm-hmm. You know, they place an offer on something, then they try and pull out. So it's a bit tough, but it doesn't matter. But regardless, this property here, number one, Blair Gowrie Court in Brighton. It's not in the Golden Mile, but it's
across,
probably...
across the road from the Golden Mile.
Hey, do you know the difference between Golden Mile of Brighton and not Golden Mile? Someone back in the 1950s said, you know what, let's have the rich side, the good side, and let's have the bad side. And the only reason there is because anything that's facing the water, you've got the Golden Mile, you've got Mulgoa, you've got Chatswood, you've got so many other streets out there across the road. It really doesn't make sense. So this one's on the market at what, $7 million? If this property was across the road, you'd be paying what? Fucking $13 million.
So it's just to live closer to the beach.
Exactly. Exactly. But you know what? This property's architecture is definitely, you know, it's so insane.
It's Japanese inspired.
Well said.
The architect.
By the way.
Yes.
Did I just point at you? By the way, this, where we're standing, it's your terrace from your master bedroom. And the master bedroom itself has a living area that leads out to a terrace like this that looks out to a tennis court. Isn't it crazy?
Phenomenal.
And the blinds here, they're actually automatic. Watch this. Alexa, put the blinds down. It's meant to go down, but obviously you need to talk very slowly, eh? Oh, it worked! See that?
That's how you do it.
That worked! That worked! Looks like I'm not having a bad day at all, you know? Very good. Alexa, put the blinds up.
She didn't hear
you. Naughty girl. Alexa, put the blinds up. There you go! I like that.
If Alexa could cook and clean, that would be perfect.
Then what would the woman do? Do you like that one? You like that one? If all the men are cooking. You good? All right, good. Anyways, all this is fun and games, but hope you guys are enjoying the vlog. Subscribe, would you?
You sure are. Hang on, you haven't even spoken about the fact that you can access the top level from this area. This is the best part.
You're worried about the top level. I'm worried about you, like, chucking you out in the water right now in the swimming pool.
You're giving me ideas for a reason?
No, because I think I could dive in there.
Yeah.
Okay, can you see this pool?
Go.
Look at the pool. Yeah. Unfortunately, I can't swim. Did you guys know that I can't swim? Oh, I can.
You couldn't swim for the life of you.
Of course I can.